said she was a magic mama, and she could throw a mean tarot and carried on without a comma. That she was someone I should know. She had a snake for a pet and an amulet, and she was breeding a dwarf, but she wasn't done yet. She had gray-green skin, a doll with a pin. I told her she was all right, but I couldn't come in. I couldn't come in right then.
So much for coming into the open of the Serpent's Lore. So I've been working on this exhibition for quite a while now, and so grateful to Giovanni for offering me this opportunity to show my work here and to create this exhibition, especially for Gallery X. Really appreciate everyone coming. I'm just so happy to see everyone here and enjoying the work, and hope you're all having a good night so far. And yeah, so I'm going to hand everything over here to Sinead, who is an independent curator and also founder of Soul Noir Festival of the Dark Art. So Sinead's work is extremely important for artists like me who work with themes of like the esoteric and dark and macabre and figurative work. So Sinead has always been a really great supporter of me, and I'm just so happy to have Sinead here to say a few words on my behalf, because I am useless at speaking. So I'll hand over to Sinead. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll say a few words if you want.
Yeah, thank you.
I think he did all right.
That's where we are. I can't see you. I can only hear you. There we are.
Thanks very much, Rebecca. I'd just like to, before I get into how brilliant Rebecca is and how important she is, I'd just like to thank Giovanni for the crucial space that he has created here in bringing together underground and gothic artists, and bringing everyone together to experience something different always. So I'd just like to give a round of applause. as Rebecca was saying, my name is Sinead Keown, I'm an independent curator and founder of Soul Noir Festival of the Dark Arts. Rebecca has exhibited with us several times, and I'd like to thank her for this invite to speak at this very important show, Rebecca's first solo show in Dublin. So we're here today to celebrate the work of Rebecca Deegan, an artist who has remained committed to the representation of the Gothic and the alternative, forged her own voice and followed her own path steadily. Deegan's work is centered on the feminine divine, occult thematics, dark folklore, and skits the peripheral of the human subconscious. Images that are familiar to us, but strangely unfamiliar, populate Deegan's practice, and her focus remains on the study of feminine power. This is most important. As a female artist, Deegan has always sought ways of understanding the ancient histories of matriarchal societies, priestesses, goddesses, and unearthly beings. In today's society, women's voices need to be heard more now than ever, and these images are an important reminder that women are powerful. The snake, long associated with the condemnation of women, is seen throughout the show as an overarching motif. Deegan states that the snake has been portrayed as something hateful within ourselves, something that deserves to be banished. In the work Bifid Tongue, we see a woman as a snake hybrid, encompassing the symbol of the snake as that of an otherworldly power. She radiates light and is unashamed of her nakedness and who she is. So that's the work just as you come in this space here. This body of work underlines the connection between the snake and the feminine divine. The snake's cultural history has seen the creature being deemed as being of divine wisdom, of fertility, and of a companion of powerful women. In the work Luna Ubilica, we see a woman, we see a woman bathed in pink light, poised before a snake egg. She holds a sacred stone up above her head as the snake egg before her releases an energy, connecting the woman with the universe. Here the snake provides the woman with the power of knowledge and of becoming. This body of work is also reflective of the artist's own personal experience. For example, using herself as a model in the work, A Place to Rest. So that's the piece with the coffin. We see her lying in a red coffin, a snake hybrid. She does not fear death. She knows that energy, knowledge, and spiritual ancestry is eternal. This is also reflected in other works such as Venus Versa Coria, where the bodies have been separated but the figure persists in their action. Rebecca Deegan is a rare, brave and fascinating artist. You are also sorely needed. Thank you for being a wonderful representation and role model for alternative artists, and I hope much more is to come. I'd like to congratulate Giovanni and Rebecca again, and can we give them a round of applause?
She said she was a magic mama, and she could throw a mean tarot, and carried on without a comma, that she was someone I should know. She had a snake for a pet, and an amulet, and she was breeding a dwarf, but she wasn't done yet. She had gray-green skin, a doll with a pin. I told her she was alright, but I couldn't come in. I couldn't come in right then.